Hello students, welcome to St. Angel's online classes. Student, we are working from home. Student, today we will discuss fifth indirect method to find distances. This method is radar method. Here radar stands for radio detection and ranging. It is used to find distance of planets or moon from the surface of earth. In this method, radar device transmits radio waves as they move with the speed of light c. Suppose at time t equal to 0, radio waves are transmitted from transmitter to a planet and it returns to receiver after time t. So these waves will travel distance x plus x, it means 2x distance. Okay students, so let radio waves sent from receiver of radar are returned to transmitter in time small t after reflection from planet, then by distance equal to speed into time. So distance traveled will be x plus x, it means 2x. As we know, radio waves moves with the speed of light and time taken is t. So distance of planet from earth is c into t divided by 2. Here c equal to 3 into 10 power 8 meter per second is speed of radio wave. Okay student, now pause the video and note it down. Student, sixth indirect method is to find size of molecule of oleic acid. Student, it is a large process, so I am discussing it step by step. First of all, we prepare 1 upon 400 centimeter cube oleic acid solution by dissolving oleic acid in alcohol. Okay, now this process is explained in this way. First of all, we take 1 centimeter cube volume of oleic acid and we pour it in 20 centimeter cube alcohol. Okay, now we mix, then we take 1 centimeter cube of this mixed solution and we dissolve it in 20 centimeter cube alcohol. Now the mixed solution will be 1 upon 400 centimeter cube solution of oleic acid. It means in such solution, in 400 centimeter cube of solution, only 1 centimeter cube of oleic acid will be present. Okay student, in this way we have prepared 1 upon 400 centimeter cube oleic acid solution. Okay, now we pour n drops of this 1 upon 400 centimeter cube oleic acid on water surface in a broad vessel. The volume of each drop is V. Suppose it is a broad vessel. Now we pour n drops of this solution. It is 1 upon 400 centimeter cube oleic acid solution. We are pouring n drops and volume of each drop. These volume of each drop. Okay, we pour n drops of this solution on water surface and we stress it on water surface carefully. Suppose it is stressed oleic acid solution on water surface. Okay student, so pour n drops of this 1 upon 400 centimeter cube oleic acid solution on water surface in a broad vessel. The volume of each drop is V. Stress this solution carefully on water surface, so it will stretch in form of very thin layer. Okay, and very thin layer of oleic acid is, as we know, alcohol can evaporate. So after pouring such solution, alcohol evaporates and only oleic acid is left on water surface, which is in very thin layer. Okay, next step, we take this very thin layer on a tissue paper, because when we stretch a tissue paper on water surface layer, then whole oleic acid will be on that tissue paper. Now we find its area using graph paper. Let this area is A. Now I am telling such process. Suppose it is graph paper. We know in graph paper each block has 1 cm³ area. That is 1 cm³. And suppose it is tissue paper on which we have taken oleic acid solution. We count those blocks which are covered by oleic acid up to half or more than half. Here it is not counted. But we can count this. Okay, student. In this way, we will count those blocks which are covered by oleic acid half or more than half. Suppose these blocks are A, then area of oleic acid will be A. So we let area of oleic acid is A. Now if assume that the thickness of this oleic acid layer is small t, then volume of oleic acid will be A area into thickness t. We can find this area by another process. As we know, volume of each drop of solution was m. Volume of each drop of solution was v and number of drops was n. So total volume of this solution poured on water surface will be nv. But we know concentration of oleic acid is only 1 upon 400 because the alcohol has been evaporated. So volume of oleic acid in this solution will be nv upon 4000. So it is nv upon 400, sorry, not 4000, it is nv upon 400. So we are looking that these two volumes are same because process of calculation was different. One was by using area into thickness, another was by using volume of oleic acid. Okay, student. Now we can compare these two volumes. A into t equal to nv upon 400. So thickness t will be nv upon 400 A. This thickness is at molecular level, so it will provide us the size of oleic acid molecule. Student, in this way we can find size of very small molecule of oleic acid solution. Okay, student. Now pause the video and note it. Student, here the area of each block is 1 cm² because 1 cm into 1 cm. Normally I have written it 1 cm³. Okay, student. Now I will discuss a define which is parallax. Then we will move next method. Parallax. Student, parallax is a phenomena of change in position of an object with respect to its surrounding when it is seen from two different locations. Suppose it is a point. We are looking this point from by our left eye, then by our right eye. Then we will see that position of this point is changed. Okay, then such phenomena is known as parallax. So we can say that it is the phenomena of change in position of an object with respect to its surrounding when it is seen from two different locations. Suppose this is an object, it is seen from two different positions P1 and P2. From here we will see it in this direction, from here we will see it in this direction. So from both positions we will see it differently. Okay, the distance between these two positions is known as basis, and angle formed at object from these two positions is known as LX. Okay student, we will discuss next method of calculating distances by indirect method, which is based on parallax. Okay, we will discuss it in next videos. Okay student, now pause the video and note it down.